several of us were commissioned. Untitled Gallery, as it was called then, was a great gallery showing, doing lots of interesting things. I had done one big body of work called Workstations, which was also a commission. And so I was looking for other commissions to apply for. These kinds of commissions that come from galleries are very open. In a sense, the theme was Sheffield and the games. Yeah, that's the theme, but you do whatever you want within that. I had been working in colour right from the beginning of my career. I was taught at what was then the Farnham Art School. The colour photographers were all there telling us all about it, like Martin Power and Paul Graham. So colour was already a big thing for me, and I love black and white photography, but I don't take to it as well as great black and white photographers do. So colour really is my medium, and I use black and white occasionally for very, very specific reasons. I've been photographing flowers in the garden all summer. And it started when I was commissioned by the Glyn Vivian Gallery in Swansea to be one of the 8 women artists to respond to the newly attributed Dilwyn archive, which originally was attributed only to John Dilwyn. More recently has been attributed also to Mary Dilwyn. And what I found in the archive was this amazing set of flower portraits where Mary, if she took them, dropped a sort of drape behind the flowers and created a studio in the garden. So I'm repeating that. And I did it in Wales and now I'm doing it in my own garden. Part of photography is the technical thing, and then there's the craft thing of printing and processing and what have you. And I don't know, there's something very special in photography that I discover more about all the time, and it's the time factor. I didn't take to digital cameras very quickly. I have just done another commission with a digital 35mm camera, but that was the first time I used it. That was in 2018, something like that. It's quite a nice studio, the garden. I didn't take to them because you just take pictures too quickly. So the slowing down to the 5.4 and 10.8 is, there's something really great about it because it gives you, there's much more thinking that goes into picture making. That's quite beautiful. I mean, the other thing I used to love about analog photography, which I still use when I'm using large format, is this time between when you shoot the image and then you process it. And for me, there's all sorts of gaps. Oh, really, they look like skeletons. Yeah, I like those. You know, I have to wait till I get enough money to process it, or I have to wait till I have the time to get to the lab or what have you. So there could be a month or sometimes 2, even 3 between shooting the pictures and seeing them. By that time, you've forgotten what you've shot. So when you see it like almost like a stranger looking at work. And that is invaluable. And when you shoot on digital, it's just instantly there in front of your eyes, and you shoot too much, so you've got too much. You can't think straight with too much material. That's, you know, if I'd lined up the flowers, I might have wanted to stick to it. And that just looked like a regular flower photo, that other one. I like the time factor that's embedded in slowing down with analog processes. It's very interesting. I'm going to try a different light reading. 2 down, a 30th of a second instead of 125th. And that should allow me to go to 40 f45. Yeah. Working. Oops, that's interesting. I just accidentally changed the setting. Okay, that's all perfect. That's not in the way, is it? No. That's all perfect. Being short is not a great thing in this situation. It doesn't even matter if it wobbles like that. It's done. Black side around. I don't ever really set out with very deliberate plans, but they're obviously there in one's head based on what you've been thinking, what you've been looking at, what you've been doing. To be honest, it's quite simple what I'm doing. I talk about it as, recording aspects of contemporary life in Britain, things that don't normally get recorded in this way, quite extensively and in detail, and trying to gather an impression of what it's like for people at a particular time in a particular place. I'm a photographer who likes to include people or other things happening rather than just an urban landscape. I like the sort of the feeling of something social going on inside the frame. The shot with a baby in is my son Felix, dressed very smartly, which is unusual. I had no plan to put him in a photograph, so I don't know why he was dressed like that exactly. If something happens in front of me like that, and it did, he was in front of me, and he just started climbing up, and I looked, and I just thought, that's great. It just looks good. It's something else added to the landscape that creates another focus or another metaphor, let's say. And, I always thought of him as, like rising out of the ashes or something, and this new vision of what Sheffield was going to be. So with the images of the nooses, and the same with the ones that sort of look like graves, I was looking for things like that, because the thing is that people were very worried about what was happening, and there were some, I found some quite distressing things going on. All this money is being invested in this very short thing, people don't even know if they're going to be able to afford to use the facilities. So it's a typical thing that seems to go on in capitalist economies, it's all this sudden investment for a particular reason in something without enough planning to make it viable for the people. So I found it slightly sad, but it just seemed like the ordinary people of Sheffield weren't necessarily getting anything much from this. So it felt, I suppose I felt cynical about it. And so, it's a sort of metaphor for they're obvious metaphors, the nooses and the graves, things aren't going to plan and it's not necessarily going to work out for the city, for the people of the city. Working on the regeneration project in Sheffield had impact on what I've done. The Regeneration 2's work that I did is not in the exhibition, but that does mark me thinking about a change. So what I did in Regeneration 2, it was my first use of a 5-4 camera. I had to photograph 6 or 7 people who were key to the development of Sheffield for the Student Games. I thought, I'm going to do this differently. I don't want to do a regular environmental portrait. So I decided to use panoramic film, the 5x4 camera, and get up in high places to photograph these people. I mean, it was slightly absurd. So I got, and I didn't photograph their faces necessarily. And one guy, suited guy, I had lying on a plank of wood in the top of a stadium. That was a breakaway moment for me, actually. That was the beginning of me thinking differently. And when I moved on to, that's the first time I've realized that, because I don't really go back to those pictures very often. Thinking about it, the Regeneration 2 portrait project that I did was the moment that I shifted all sorts of things.